course, one more time, if you our neighbors, if you listen to this message, God bless you. And to our friends and brothers and sisters on social media, God bless you too. When you hear this message, the Lord might add a blessing to his word. Revelation chapter 9, verse 20 and 21, the title of the message is, They Repented Not, They Refused to Repent. Let's read the scripture. Revelation chapter 9, verse 20, And the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues, they repented not. They refused to repent of their works of their hands, that they should not worship devils and idols of gold and silver and brass and stone and of wood which neither can see or hear or walk. Verse 21. Neither repented, they refused to repent, neither repent they of their murders, of their sorceries, of their fornication, of their stealing, of their thefts. And the Bible right here on chapter 9, if you read the Bible, John the Revelator, one of the disciples of Jesus Christ, is in the island of Patmos, and he's taken up into heaven to receive a revelation from the Lord. That's why this book is called Revelation, because he sees, he experienced a number of elements and things that are yet to happen, that are going to happen in the future. And right here, John is showing us of a situation where he sees angels. If you read verse 14 and 15, you read right there that the Lord is commanded the four angels that are tied, that are bound, that are hitting in the Euphrates River over there by Egypt, he commanded them to kill 1/3 of the population, and with plagues and pestilence and however they wanted, the Lord commanded these angels to kill 1/3 of the population right there on Revelation chapter 9, verse 14 and 15. So the Bible says, on John 9:39, also Jesus Christ, this is the words of Jesus Christ, says, For judgment I came into this world, so the blind will see. So God right here is sending judgment upon humanity. He's sending judgment upon mankind. God is tired of the condition of mankind. And you say, what is the condition of mankind? We're not talking about obese. We're not talking about somebody with a medical condition. We're talking about the sinful nature of man. Mankind, society loves sin. Society much rather embrace sin than something that is godly, than something that is of God. And God right here is tired. He's saying, I'm going to send this judgment to the land of the free and the home of the brave, in the way he said, and he kills 1/3 of the population through his angels. When you go to a courtroom, the judge many times cast a judgment upon somebody, and when he cast out the judgment upon somebody of a situation, he opens the eyes of the courtroom, he opens the eyes of the criminal, he opens the eyes of those who are accusing the criminal, and he explains the law and the consequences, and he explains what is going to be the punishment and the judgment for the crime that you committed. If you go to a courtroom where God is the just God and all his ways are just, judgment, and he's judging this world, and he's sending a plague, a pestilence to kill 1/3 of the population right here on the book of Revelation. And you say, well, that's not right. Yes, it's right. All his ways are judgment, and he's a just God. He has given mankind enough time to repent of their sins, but mankind does not want to repent of their sins. They don't even want to hear the word repent. The word repent is offensive. They don't want to hear from the pulpits of America. The word repent is not proclaimed from the pulpits of America. Long time ago, the pulpits of America stopped preaching of repentance and stopped calling people to repent of their sins. And instead, they blessing all kinds of sin, fornication, adultery, idolatry from the pulpit. And God is saying it's enough. I have four angels over there by the Euphrates River, and I'm going to release them, and they're going to kill 1/3 of the population. And you say, well, God is love. But God is fire. is a consuming fire. And he's tired. He was tired already during the flood. Remember, he told Noah, build an ark. I'm going to destroy all flesh. And the heavens are open. The windows are open. The windows of heaven were open. And the fountains of the deep were open. And this whole entire world was covered with water. And people drowned in their sin. People was begging for mercy, but it was too late. For 100 and some years, Noah was preaching repentance. Repent, repent, repent. And these people make fun of Noah when he was having services outside his home. And people was making fun of Noah when he was building an ark. And people were making fun of Noah when he gathered his family and his brothers and sisters, and they hold a service in the front yard. They repented now. God sent the judgment, the flood, and it killed all flesh. All of them, babies, all young, tall, black, white, all of them were killed. God was tired. He said, I am not going to fight with men. I repented that I may create this man. And he did it again on Sodom and Gomorrah. And Sodom and Gomorrah, he sent a little bit of heaven. He sent heaven down in a form of brimstone. And he burned Sodom and Gomorrah. And only 3 people that obeyed and listened to the instructions of the angels left the city. And they were saved. In the case of Noah, it was only 8. Because God is the one who shut the door of the ark. It was not even Noah who said, okay, it's enough. Only you are going to work on in this ark. No, God gave them plenty of time. Even the Bible says that he gave the animals 7 days to get into the ark. And all of them, they only needed 7 days to get into the ark. And they were preaching to mankind for 100 years. And that was not enough time for mankind to repent. America, how much time do you need to repent of your sins? How much time? They've been preaching Jesus Christ since the Mayflower landed in America. They brought Christianity to this nation. How much longer do you need to repent of your sins? God is going to release his angels and 1/3 of the population is going to be destroyed. Are you going to be among those who are going to be destroyed? Or you're going to be among those who are being left behind to see the destruction? Or you're going to be one of those who are going to make it into the kingdom of heaven? Highway to hell. They play that stupid music, that ungodly music, and they make fun. Highway to hell. That's exactly where you're going, but you need to sing instead the narrow path. The way to heaven is very narrow, very small, and you need to get into that path, not in the highway to hell. Revelation chapter 9, verse 20 and 21. And it says right there, neither and those who survive, they repented not. So there's people who's going to survive. Only 1/3 of the population are going to be killed through this judgment. But those who are not killed, the Bible says, they decide not to repent of their sins. You are watching God. You are watching his angels. He released his judgment, his awful wrath upon mankind and upon humanity and upon all flesh. And you are left behind to see that. And you survived and you repented not of your sins. You love your sin too much. You love your fornication too much. You love your stealing too much. You love your gambling too much. You love your cheating too much. You love your lying too much. You love your television too much. You love your flesh too much. Too much. If you see the judgment of God upon this land and doesn't move your heart, it doesn't bring fear into your heart. There's something wrong with you. You are a reprobate, the Bible calls you. Reprobate. You have gone reprobate. You worship the creation more than the Creator. They repented not. The Bible says they will continue worshiping idols. They have watched 1/3 of the population killed by the wrath of God, and they continue worshiping idols. Bible says they continue worshiping demons. They have watched God kill one third of the population and they still worshiping devils. They have watched one third of the population being killed by the awful wrath of God, and yet they still continue murdering children at the abortion clinic. They have watched one third of the population being killed by the awful wrath of God, and they're still witches, they're still sorcerers, they're still waking up in the morning, opening the zodiac and reading these horoscopes. They have watched these angels kill one third of the population and they're still living in fornication. They have watched one third of the population being killed and they're still stealing. That's what the Bible says right here in Revelation chapter 9, verses 20 and 21. They repented not of all these things. They repented not. You will think that during these times of, call it whatever you want, pandemic, COVID-19, crisis, people will repent of the sins. You will think the people will change their ways. But if you get on this 81 towards Bristol, Tennessee, stop on a gas station and you'll see a gambling machine. You will see a slot machine and you'll watch people putting their money in this machine and playing in those machines. And some of them may be using their unemployment money to play and gambling on these machines. They repented not. They see the plagues, they see the pestilence, and they repented not. I watch the news around the world. In Mexico, they have many prostitutes on the streets working. They don't call them prostitutes no more because it's not politically correct. Now they call them sexual workers. So these sexual workers, these prostitutes, they come up with a video saying, we're starving. There's no customers. What are we going to do? People are scared to go out on the streets. They don't want to come near us for our services. But we come up with a solution. We carry hand sanitizer and we put masks when we perform our duties. That is not a solution. You're just wicked and you love your sin. And instead of finding a decent job, you find a way to continue in sin. They repented not. They repented not. El Salvador. You might be familiar with the MS-13. President Trump is trying to get rid of the MS-13 in America. Well, they're all, most of them, a lot of them, they're over there in El Salvador, in Central America. This last weekend was the record killing on homicides. The gangs went on the streets and start killing as many as they can. They repented not. They continued murdering, Bible says. Not long ago, how long we've been in quarantine, and other countries have been in quarantine longer than America. The Bible says they continue worshiping idols. Holy Week went by, and the Catholic Church and some other cults were carrying pieces of wood and were carrying pieces of idols, and they were worshiping idols. They repented not, just like the Bible says. Here in America this weekend, people can really stay away from gambling. People must gamble. Arkansas Derby took place in America because we stopped everything except the horse race. We must have the horse race to survive, I believe. They repented not. They moved the Kentucky Derby to September, but the Arkansas Derby took place and people was right there because that's an essential situation in your life. They opened up some beaches in America. People run to the beach naked. They repented not. The liquor stores still in business. They repented not. The abortion clinics still in business. They repented not. Chicago, April 2020. On one day, there was 21 shootings killing a six-year-old. They repented not of their murders through this pandemic, through this plague, through these judgments. They repented not, just like the Bible says. And they continue stealing, they continue killing, they continue with sorcery, with spells. There's a bunch of witches who are casting out spells against the coronavirus. That stuff don't work. They repented not. It's another witch, warlock, Kenneth Copeland, casting out spells against coronavirus. Mm-hmm. Yeah. There's a guy in Nevada who entered into a medical facility and stole masks. They put him in jail. Another one in Hong Kong entered into a hospital and stole masks. They put him in jail too. They repented now. They continue stealing just like the Bible says. San Francisco. You leave your car on the street, they have a problem with thieves. They're stealing tires right now. They're leaving your car in blocks. They repented not of their stealing. They continue stealing. They still refuse to repent. And the doctrine of repentance must be preached. The doctrine of repentance, the word repents, must be preached from the pulpits of America. Amen. John the Baptist in Matthew chapter 3, verse 8 and 2, he said it himself. He came out of the wilderness, baptizing people, preaching and saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent and produce fruit, he says. As you go preach saying the kingdom of heaven is at hand, and then you see Jesus Christ right there on Matthew 4, right after John the Baptist preached and says, repent for the kingdom is at hand. Jesus Christ gets baptized by John the Baptist, and Jesus Christ come out saying the same thing. From that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, repent for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent. The apostles of Jesus Christ, the people in the Bible preach repentance. You have Jeremiah, the weeping prophet. Jeremiah chapter 26, verse 1 to 3. He says, in the beginning of the reign of Joachim, the son of Josiah, king of Judah, this word came from the Lord. Thus says the Lord, stand up in the courtyards of the Lord's house and speak to all the citizens of Judah which come to worship in the Lord's temple. All these words that I command you to speak, do not diminish a word. Perhaps everyone will listen and repent. And then I'll repent on the calamity that's coming their way. Perhaps every time we listen, that I might relent my calamity that is the calamity that is coming. And Jeremiah, he's telling him to preach repentance. On the book of Acts chapter 2, verse 38, you have Peter in the day of Pentecost when they accused him of being drunk. Where they accused and being taken over by the Holy Spirit, Peter got up and said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Peter is preaching repentance. You go to the book of Acts in chapter 17, verse 30. Paul is preaching repentance too. It is command. God commands every day, every man, everywhere to repent. God commands every man, everywhere to repent. So today, right here in blue, in this city of West Virginia, God is commanding you to repent. Jesus Christ, on the book of Luke, chapter 13, verse 3, a famous verse that most people know by heart. 13 verse 3, I tell you nay, but except you repent, you all shall likewise perish. Luke 15:7. I say unto you, that likewise joy shall be in heaven over one sinner that repented more than over 99 just persons We need no repentance. There is joy in heaven when one sinner says, it's enough. I don't want to be a murderer. I don't want to be a thief. I don't want to be a drunk. I don't want to be a prostitute. I don't want to be a sinner. There is joy in heaven. Luke 5, verse 32. I came not to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. Mark 1:15, repent and believe the gospel. Ezekiel 18:32, it says, repent and live. If you repent, you are guaranteed that you will live. That's what the Bible says. Repentance brings salvation. But John the Revelator saw the vision of all these people after experiencing the judgment of God. They repented not. Not be one of those who repented not. Be one of those who are going to be marching in to the kingdom of heaven. And you say, that's not what you got to preach today. What should we preach today? Let's go to Matthew chapter 10. Why are you preaching repentance? Why are you saying that? You offend me. This is Jesus Christ on Matthew 10, verse 7. God is commanding his disciples. He's telling them what to preach. And he says on verse 6, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And as ye go, preach saying the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And remember, Jesus Christ said it himself in Matthew 4:17, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Matthew 20, Luke 24:47. What else should we preach, preacher? And repentance and remission of sin shall be preached in his name among the nations, beginning at Jerusalem. Amen. That's why I preach repentance. Because it's a commandment from the Lord. It's what the Lord Jesus Christ told his disciples to preach. He said, in repentance and remission of sin shall be preached in his name among all nations. That's why I preach repentance. The doctrines of repentance is not being preached anymore from the pulpits of America. The doctrine of repentance is not welcome in a lot of churches in America. Sinners does not want to hear the word repentance in America. But the Bible says, 2 Chronicles 7:14, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their evil ways, then I will hear from heaven. I'll forgive their sins and I will heal their land. No stimulus check. No more money through the Senate and Congress. Is the repentance of his people. Is the confession of sin. Bible says, if you don't confess your sin, you shall not prosper. You wonder why nothing goes wrong. Why everything goes wrong, I'm sorry. You wonder why your money is not enough and you even probably have more problems now. Because you don't confess your sin. But your sins are going to be exposed one day. Because God is keeping record of everything that comes out of your mouth. And everything that you do. And everything will be exposed. And like a righteous judge, he will cast out his judgment. And if you're not repentant of your sin, then your name is not going to be written on the book of life. And the consequence, the punishment for that is the lake of fire. One third of the population were killed through the awful wrath of God. And yet they repented not. And we see it today. They keep murdering. They keep going to the beach like everything is good. Arkansas Derby. Why do we worry? The government is giving us checks. Why do we worry? You have to worry about your soul. Prepare to meet thy God. Today, when grace is still available to all men, the Bible says. His mercies are new every day. It doesn't matter what your sin is. What matters is that you acknowledge that you're a sinner and that you need salvation. What matters is that you acknowledge that you need to repent of your sin. But today, people have created their own rules. People have created their own gods. And they have put the God of the Bible aside. They don't believe on the God of the Bible. They believe of the God who's in the White House, and they believe on the God who's in Hollywood, and they go by the standards of Hollywood and by the standards of the White House. And the law of the law is perfect, the Bible says. Everything that comes through Nashville and Hollywood is trash, is garbage. And you say, well, we have good precedent. We still have abortions. We still have same-sex marriage. That's not godly. You want to know what a godly king did before? 1 Kings chapter 11:15. King Asa did what was right in the law, what was right in the eyes of the Lord, and he expelled, he took out all the Sodomites of the land of Israel. How are we going to get out of this economic problem now? Is they're not worried so much about the people who are dying. Now they're worried about the economic situation. How are you going to get out? Through repentance. Through the Bible. Through God. Through more godliness. Through more preaching of sound doctrine. Not witches and warlocks like Kenneth Copeland casting out spells. No. Through preaching. Through Bible that calls people to repentance, that tells people that what you're doing is wrong. It's wrong in the eyes of God. It is not my standards. It's the standards that are right here on this book. 66 books. If God calls him a sin, it's a sin. You can call yourself a sexual worker, or you can call yourself an addict, or you can call yourself whatever you want. God called you a sinner. And he came for sinners, not for the just. He came to call sinners to repent, not the just. But yet, they repented not, the Bible says. Father God, we